My, 26 male, wife, 27 female, cheated but my family are taking her side and making things harder for me. Sorry if it's too long, I tried to write things that happened to me in past 3 months and I am not great in English, so there are probably a lot of mistake in the test. We grow up almost together, our parents were close friends and we lived in the same building. I used to hate her when I was a kid because she was always better than me and I can say she received more love from my parents than me. We both got accepted in best uni in our country but they only held a party for her and their excuse was, she ranks second in whole country while I was only top 50. But she herself cared for me more than anyone else, she confessed to me when I was 17 and we got married when I was 23, 3 years ago, we had a great marriage until 3 months ago I came home and before going in I stopped to smoke a cigarette. Then I heard my wife's voice from window, I went closer to talk to her and it was when I heard her saying, we should end this, it's wrong, I love Dan, what she call me, don't call me again. I felt like I wanted to throw up my stomach, I felt really really bad but after a few minutes I calmed down and went in. I didn't say anything to her, I was trying to convince myself maybe I am wrong. Later my wife left the house to go to gym, she always leave her phone at home when she's going to gym. After struggling for few minutes I decided to check her phone, I can open it with my fingerprints, it was her decision to add my fingerprints so I can use it in case of emergency. I find the chats very fast, they've been talking since 1 month ago. I was expecting that she had already deleted anything about him but well it was all there. I knew the guy from high school, he had nothing but looks. After reading the chats I realized they got in contact in a school gathering party and my wife asked him few questions about photos since he's a model and then they had a meeting which I didn't know about. After that they were more intimate and went on a second date. He kissed her in that date and they talked about it in chat. It was for 2 days ago. I had enough, I stopped reading. I wrote, I want divorce. How did you do that to me, on paper and left it on top of phone with chat still open and left the house. I turned off my phone and went to my parents' house, next day when I woke up she was there and I soon realized my parents think we had a problem and want to help us. They were keep saying, married couples always fight and we should overcome these issues, I was really tired, angry and when my father repeated almost the same thing I shouted she fucking cheated on me, she cheated on me and then I realized I am crying. I left house and went to my parents' house. I expected my parents to take my side and stop bothering me but next day my mother called me and said, she explained everything to me, she's really sorry, it's not that bad, she didn't had any close relationship with him, we should be forgiving. I was desperate, I said no, I want divorce and she keep telling those things again. And she was saying I am overreacting, it was only a small mistake and it's like they had sex, they just meet 2 times. I hang up. Few days later on went to my parents' house to talk to my father about selling the house after divorce and he said, I'll only allow you in my house with your wife and closed the door. It was second saddest moments in my life after when I realized my wife cheated. It's been 3 months and my parents keep asking me to forgive her and don't allow me in their house. We're still married because she refused to sign the divorce papers and in my country if one of partners refused to get divorce it will take lots of time and they have to first participate in 3 sessions with a therapist. And she's been following me whenever she can, crying asking me to give her another chance and seeing her like this make me really sad because I really loved her. But I just can't forgive her, I just can't trust her anymore and not think about how she cheated on me. I don't know anymore what to do with my life, how to deal with my parents or even how to make her stop. Please. In my country unless she do something serious like hurting me I can't sue her for anything and honestly I don't even want to do that if it was possible. Stick to your guns. Cut them all out of your life and move on. Tell them all to fuck themselves. You need space and your wife and your parents aren't giving you any of it. You need to clear your head and process all of this but your parents are just pushing you further away by punishing you instead of her. Your parents are terrible people especially when they favored your wife since your childhood. You need to get away from all of them. Try moving somewhere new, somewhere away from them, somewhere you can start fresh. Damn bruh, tell your parents if they aren't on your side. After you divorce her and get married again and have kids. They will never be allowed to see them. Maybe that will scare them. Do those 3 therapy sessions if that's what it takes to divorce her. Also, cut your parents out of your life until they realize how shitty they've treated you and beg for forgiveness or however long you decide. Do the therapy sessions and get it over with. Your wife cannot be trusted. Once that's over, continue with a therapist so you can move on. And limited contact with your parents moving forward. It's not up to your parents to decide what does or doesn't work for you. Up. Try checking out R. Surviving Infidelity for help. I would move forward with the divorce. She doesn't even seem repentant. Wife's male co-worker messages late. She defends it. Need advice. First time posting. There's so much more to this story. But I'll start with the most recent. Without all of the backstory. My wife of 15 plus years has a divorced male co-worker that sends casual, could be taken as flirtatious messages, sometimes late at night. Yesterday a message came through at about 1:30 a.m. She sleeps through everything, I wake up to everything. It wakes me up. I've explained how I felt about it. How I see it as inappropriate and disrespectful. My thought was that she would at least say to stop messaging so late. Ideally she would end the possibly flirtatious messages. But she pretty much did the opposite and defended it. It turned into an argument about how there's nothing wrong with it, and she doesn't see an issue because it doesn't wake her up. There's so much more that's driving me crazy. But I would like opinions on the basis of this first. Please share. Found the edit button. I will add that I've met the guy, and believe that there is nothing going on. It's principle and respect mostly. We got together young and dumb. Had kids right away. No good examples of healthy relationships, etc. I was controlling at times when we were younger. We both have lots of regrets. But for years now I've been on a continuous improvement path. Trying to talk things through. Work things out. Find resolutions to end the toxic cycles we have. This is currently the biggest one. We are here again. Thank you everybody. Wasn't sure how I was going to add info, history. But it looks like the best way is to comment on relayed comments. There's so much. Adding some backstory from comments. Part of the cycle that we're back at now. I still believe nothing has happened. She mostly just sits at home and I couldn't even find a window of when something could have happened. Yes, I started paying attention to where she was, etc. after all of this and more. I had to show her how all the signs of an affair were there, other than me knowing where she is. I also don't think it's an emotional affair. She is not an emotional person, if that makes sense. I am very emotional, loving, affectionate towards her. She is more of an anti-social, quiet, homebody that would rather do nothing most of the time. Copied text from comments. We argued for days about this. There were two male co-workers. I had to go to extreme lengths just to get her to see how she was leading them on and the extreme inappropriateness and disrespect. They are both much older and I believe her that nothing was happening. But she said, "I love you too," to another man. It started with a lot of, getting to see, not getting to see you at work, you're my favorite person, when am I going to see you again, I miss you, etc. She says it was all innocent. Like old man type stuff? IDK. One of his messages was some form of I love you. Hers was I love you too. Not love ya bud. Not love you too pal. Not all we all love you here. Also adding, we.do not live in a common law state. But we.do live in a state that heavily rules in favor of the mother no matter what. I'm terrified of the conditions my kids would be living in if it were just them and her. We have discussed separating. I have tried to lay out a plan to make it amicable and make it work. She has made it clear that it would be the opposite. There's a bigger issue here, like why she allows someone to text her and be flirtatious when she is married. This isn't going to end up anywhere good unless she squashes it. Well, it's certainly rude and dismissive of your wife to claim there's nothing wrong with these messages waking you up. She could at the very least turn her notifications on silent, but it seems she doesn't care to even hide her inappropriate relationship. Yikes. What other ways has she checked out on you? I assume that's part of the background. How does she defend a man messaging her at inappropriate hours? Okay, there are a few things going on here, each with its own separate issues. 1. Your wife's coworker is texting late at night 2. Your wife's coworker is texting semi-flirtatious messages 3. Your wife's phone is waking you up. 4. Messages from the coworker are waking you up. Etc. etc. What you have every right to be annoyed with that your wife's phone is waking you up. That is a 100% valid complaint. You deserve to get good sleep, and if her gadgets are waking you up, that is not right. That is something she should care about. I would suggest start with that. At the very least ask her to put her phone on silent or DND mode. This behavior right here is probably why her coworker is divorced lol. Do you know how disrespectful it is to text someone at 1:30 a.m. in the morning flirtatiously when they're clearly married? She's enabling it. The fact that she doesn't see a problem with this behavior is a massive red flag. Massive. At the very least, your wife's a selfish idiot. At the worst, she's probably already planning on or has cheated. Kind of seems like something is going on, emotional cheating perhaps. clearly inappropriate. Not sure why this is even a question. Dude, is your wife the popular girl at work who gets all the attention? I mean, if the needs of her casual co-workers and her need to flirt with them those of her husband, you really need progress to the ultimatum. She, 33F, wouldn't scroll up to show me, M32, messages from another guy. Hi folks. I went to my, now ex, girlfriend's a few nights ago. We were together 9 months. It's been rocky to say the least. She has dumped me multiple times by WhatsApp amongst other things. We were sat relaxing in her garden, and a tough topic came up, about some guy that's been giving her attention at her work. She has said several times for several months to my face, and has swore on her 5YO daughter's life, to which I didn't ask her to do, that the last time she spoke to this guy was face to face several months ago to tell him she had a boyfriend, me. I have had a gut feeling for months. I went with the nuclear option and calmly asked her to show me the last correspondence with this guy. She held her phone in her hand whilst I was sat next to her. She showed a message from him from last Thursday saying, "Thank you gorgeous XXXXXX less than 3, and absolutely refused to go any higher, on principle. I feel guilty for asking her on a basis of privacy, but I felt like it was eating away at me like acid. I dumped her on the spot and abruptly noped the fuck out of there with all my shit. Calmly, I also gave her her key. She then bombards me with messages after I left saying she was trying to do a WhatsApp, iCloud backup from WhatsApp to prove her innocence, but had deleted all of her chats by accident doing this. She also said she would get screen grabs from this guy to prove it. They haven't arrived, surprise surprise. She still categorically denies anything. I did go no contact for a few days, but then unblocked her and stated I would like to still be friends as it wouldn't have ever worked as partners, or at least business associates. I am a businessman and she is an estate agent, she rents commercial units to me. I also hate being on bad terms with anyone in life. She has said she wants neither, and that she has done nothing wrong. I have done a full sexual health screen just in case. She also keeps asking me for money despite me dumping her. I was giving her £4,500 per month to help on bills she had got behind on. I believe she is financially irresponsible as she has 300 pairs of shoes and hundreds of designer garments. With the above in mind, I felt a bit childish, but I told her to ask the guy she was messaging who runs a men's mental health charity for money, instead of me that runs businesses which can be cutthroat at the best of times, especially after this year I felt better for saying it. What annoys me the most is this guy runs this charity but didn't think of my mental health when he was snaking on my lady. I have no idea what has gone off. Who she's been with, what she said to anyone. Hurts beyond belief. I think everything she has said in the 9 months was all lie after lie after lie. Did I do the right thing dumping her? Have I overreacted? Thanks folks, have a good weekend. Buddy, you know why she didn't scroll up. You made the right call, especially stopping giving her cash. Block and drop as fast as you can. I was giving her £4,500 per month to help on bills she had got behind on. Gee, I wonder why she's trying so hard to keep you. And #X200B. Did I do the right thing dumping her? Have I overreacted? Absolutely not. Your response was swift, decisive, and you stuck to your principles and boundaries in the relationship. You have good instincts and I can reassure you that you have made a wise decision. Find someone that respects you and wants to be with you for the person you are and not just because you're helping her with finances and bills. Lol, holy fuck dude, imagine swearing on your child's life, and then breaking that swear. Jesus Christ, that's like, next level bad human being. My gut instinct is you 100% did the right thing. First of all, the whole, always breaking up with me, things is reason alone to do break it off. All of this is super sus. I'll admit I've deleted chats by accident before, including my fiancé's GC with her girls by mistake. But the pure fact she refused to scroll up, on principle, is fucked up enough. And #X200B. If she really is struggling for money, she can pay off her debts by selling her designer wear. It's no longer your responsibility and it's probably best if you keep your contact with her strictly professional. Y'all grown as fuck, so there's no reason for you to be paying her bills, my guy. I think you handled it perfectly. My parents always told me to follow your gut and ignore your heart. I had the unshakable feeling my girlfriend at the time was seeing someone else whenever jobs put a little distance between us. I just didn't expect the other guy to be my best friend. You know the person you're dating and if you get the intuition that something is up, you're probably now wrong. That being said, her story sounds pretty suspicious at best. Along with the fact that she wouldn't be totally transparent about what she was doing after what you've seen is more than enough to end a relationship, IMHO. Truthfully, I wish I handled my breakup as mature as you did. Just focus on yourself and keeping the Kong's crown on your head. You sound much better off. Wow. A Reddit relationship thread where the man had balls and did the right thing. I don't know what I am going to do. So disillusioned. She was trying to do a WhatsApp, iCloud backup from WhatsApp to prove her innocence, but had deleted all of her chats by accident doing this. Reite okay sign face with rolling eyes, such a tired cliche. I'd dump her for lack of creativity. That's the best she can do? Girlfriend thinks I need therapy because of how I reacted to a home break-in. I, 24M, grew up in the projects all my life. It's not as crazy as some other neighborhoods, but over the years I've seen a little of everything. Where I live now is generally safer, but every now and then shit happens. My girlfriend of 2 years doesn't like how I reacted to what happened over a month ago. So sometimes she stays over at my place. Thing is, she gets up super early to go to work. I'm talking 5 a.m. and gets in at 5:30. I'm still sleeping. That morning I heard some moving around and I thought it was her getting ready for work. It was still kinda dark in my apartment. So thinking it was her, I yelled out, "You can turn on the light if you want." Literally the noises I was hearing stopped, then I remember before I knocked out again I checked my phone and saw it was 5:20 and said, "Babe, you're gonna be late." Then I fell asleep. When I woke up I texted my girl asking if she got to work on time and she asked why wouldn't she. She confirmed she defo wasn't at the house at that time, so it was obviously someone else. I checked my apartment and yeah, my TV was gone and the kitchen window was open. I mean, they didn't take anything else because I'm a broke ass 20-something year old, cold sweat smile, tears of joy man shrugging light skin tone, just got a lock on my windows and bought another used TV after that. But to me I think it's funny because in my mind, imagine what the fuck the robber was thinking hearing me tell them they can turn on the light, tears of joy IDK, that's just me. My girlfriend more serious about it though. She doesn't get how I'm not scared right now knowing they could have done something to me. I didn't think about it like that, but nothing happened to me in the end, so in my head why focus on that, you know? It's not the first time in my life someone has broken into my home. It happened a couple times growing up. But now I'm up when my girlfriend stays over and walk her to her car in the mornings before she leaves for work. I've asked her too if she's okay or if she feels safe here at my place. So we've talked about how she feel about it, but she thinks I have a problem because I'm not bothered by it aside from being annoyed I had to get another TV. I've told her I'm fine, but she thinks I need therapy, that maybe I'm not coping right over it. I'm really confused why it needs to be a big deal. It's not that I don't open up about my feelings. I can talk about my personal shit and what's going on with me. But for this incident I don't feel anything. How do I get her to understand that, or is she right and I'm thinking it's funny as a coping mechanism? I think you'd probably, maybe not IDK, feel a little differently if you'd known there was an intruder in your house while it was happening. Instead you just thought it was your girlfriend and then realized they stole a TV, so it's more removed and comical. I don't agree that you need therapy, but I'd maybe try to discuss it with her from that angle. I think I'm not as rattled because I didn't really know what happened until it was over, angle, rather than the I'm not pressed about a break-in because I grew up in the projects, angle. I would laugh too if I unknowingly told my robber they could make it easier on themselves. I reacted the same way when I found out someone had been hiding in the stockroom at work so they could rob the place after I left. I mean, it's creepy, but I'm just happy they weren't a murderer. If you don't feel like a victim, I don't think you'd need to go to therapy. Sounds like you don't have anxiety and don't come up with scary what-if scenarios. Sounds like you looked at the bright side and moved on. So people handle things differently. I had a house burned down. Everyone made it out except the cats. I had just gotten out of the army and didn't have a job yet and had a friend that lives a few houses down from me as the fireman worked. I was joking that I was going to have sucked dick for coke to sell the coke cause I'm homeless now. My one neighbor was losing her damn mind and how could I be making jokes? AAAGGGGHHHBH. I'm so annoyed for you. I mean, you can't do anything about it now. Just be more vigilant. I am sorry, but I keep picturing the thief being like, such a cool victim. Wanting me to turn on the light. I've been in similar situations. It's over with. Lock your doors or be more vigilant. I grow up in rough neighborhoods too and some stuff just don't affect me anymore, so I get it. Just tell your girl you're happy that you still have you life and able to see another day and you're not stress over material things that can be replaced. Just upgrade your locks and security and be safe. We all react differently, and she needs to understand that. About 15 years ago, a couple of huge dudes pushed into my house and roughed me up. They were looking for my neighbor, whose boyfriend was selling drugs. They wanted to fuck her up to get back at him, but found me instead. I talked them down, and made them realize it wasn't me they were looking for, and I managed to make them leave without hurting me. Yes, I was freaked out, and did add some security features to my house. But that was it. I just got over it. If my husband was home, in the same way as if you were aware they were in your home, things would have turned out very differently. But they didn't. You don't have to live in fear of what could have happened, and you certainly don't need therapy for it. Kinda reminds me of when I was sleeping at my boyfriend's apartment and we heard gunshots. He woke right TF up and was scared. He shook hard too. I was like, "What's wrong?" He's like, "You don't hear the gunshots?" Few seconds late, there was more shots. I'm like, "Yeah, now go back to sleep." I was out. He couldn't go back to sleep cause there was more shots. Plus he was ducking a little. In the morning, he told me something was wrong with me and I need help cause he couldn't understand how I slept through multiple shots fired. I was tired and grew up in a rough neighborhood. IDK woman shrugging, medium dark skin tone woman shrugging, medium dark skin tone woman shrugging, medium dark skin tone. Everyone reacts differently to things.